Welcome to Hyderabad, the capital of Andhra Pradesh, India, and home to over 10 million people. I'm Sid Owen. As well as an actor, I'm also an ambassador for a water charity called drop4drop. We're here for a week to highlight India's water crisis. With me is Simon, my best mate and CEO of the charity, and our friend Rob, who's the owner of Due South Restaurant in Brighton. There's an estimated 200 million people in India without access to clean drinking water. And having just arrived, we're already on our way to see the Jengu community in the city's largest slum.
At least 6,000 families are living in here. Just gonna take a look round. 14 members of one family in one little hut.
This slum does have a water supply, although the government only turn it on for 1 hour a day. It doesn't, however, have any sewer network, so any waste literally ends up on their doorstep.
I'm just going to go and have a look at their main water supply for 120,000 people. It's crazy. Certainly humbles you, that's for sure.
Basic human right, how does the government not make them do it? Well, you can see there's no drainage off it, so the dirty water is just hanging around and stagnating.
The flow from that pipe isn't nearly enough, and they're not pumping it up because they're switching on. It's a government automated thing where they actually just allow water for a certain amount of time.
And leaving water sitting about like that, that's what causes illnesses.
Totally. We've only been in India a few hours and now it's time to move on. Whilst the slums have very little access to water, it's the government that restricts this, not the availability. Now we're off to rural India to meet the people that need our help the most.
It's just mad, you know, and that slum we went to earlier was right bang in the city. And it's crazy that that's just happening and you've got all this sort of happening around it. And anyway, now we're on our way to Kakinada, just jumping on the train. Got a nice little train journey ahead of us. Only about 11 or 12 hours, should be fun. This is where we're crashing. Not too bad, is it?
How was that?
Yeah, lovely.
Pure luxury.
As soon as I've arrived, the scale just seems bigger and bigger, doesn't it? It's the Kakinada, it was a village. We've driven for 15 minutes and just through open sewers, and the same thing as we saw before. Which I agree with you. It may be possible. It may be possible, but it's going to take the rest of our lives, and then we're going to have to pass it on to the next generation. It'll take the rest of their lives.
There are more people in India without access to clean drinking water than the whole of Africa. And each pound donated to drop4drop guarantees someone that privilege for life.
Well, we've just stopped. And this is another village with no water. We literally just drove past these people. And this guy was saying that where there is a lack of water, well, they do actually get it from the canal, which is pretty nasty anyway, because it's stagnant, it's full of all sorts. As Simon said before, you know, cut your life expectancy of like 30 years. And instead of drinking water, they're on the old sauce. Crazy.
Water. He's saying that we have to go more than 2 kilometers far water. From 30 years we are facing this water problem. No one had bothered about us, no one had cared about us. You are the people, first time you came to us to see us. And we are happy for that.
Your baby, how old is he? 11 years old, he looks like a baby.
This is a prime example of what a lack of water does do. And, well, not just a lack of water, but, you know, drinking dirty water.
Polio.
Yeah.
Polio. God bless you. Where do they get their water? Where?
They're getting from canal.
From the canal.
Canal.
And they drink water from the canal.
That is dirty water.
They drink this. Yeah? They don't boil it. Next week, yeah? We start to put water in for you. It was an unexpected little stopover that was. I thought we were on our way back. And that was pretty shocking, really. You know, not just saying it, but 70% of those people didn't look right. And it just goes to show you, you know, sort of down to the water. We're finally here to witness one of the wells that we've installed from drop4drop. Supplies over 1,000 people fresh, clean drinking water. Let's go and have a look. It looks pretty smart to me. This is it. Water that, you know, it changes so many people's lives. Hey, for me?
Yes.
Ah, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. And one for you. One for you. Yeah? Come on. Yeah. Compared to that one we saw in the Jengu tribe in Hyderabad yesterday, this is a piece of machinery, isn't it? 263 feet through all the salt, and it's bringing up fresh, clean drinking water. People out there, we need to keep pledging money and to support this charity, drop4drop, because it really does make a difference. So thank you. And we have water! Yay! Thank you.